I'm what you might consider a super fan of the reality game show Big Brother.
Wait. Before you click off the video, don't worry. This video is not about Big Brother. It's about the winner of the most recent season. A 24-year-old bartender named Jackson Michie. A man who was canceled on live international television despite the fact that he did literally nothing wrong. But you don't have to take my word for it. I'll prove it to you with a little something I like to call evidence. Something that the other side doesn't seem to have. So, if you hate cancel culture as much as I do, then it's time to grab some tissues and lotion, because this video is gonna make you come like a billion times.
In just moments, 16 complete strangers from across America will move into this house with one goal in mind: to be the last house guest standing and win the $500,000 grand prize. But it won't be easy. For the next 3 months, they'll be completely cut off from the outside world. No internet, no TV, no cell phones. Only these cameras and microphones to capture every emotionally charged moment like never before. It's summertime, America, and that can only mean one thing. It's time for Big Brother.
Okay, here's the basic context of what you need to understand about Big Brother. 16 contestants live in the same house for 100 days, and each week the house guests vote somebody out until there are only two people left, and then the people who got voted out come back and vote for the winner between the two people. It's a stressful marathon of social politics, lying, cheating, deception, whatever it takes to get you in those final two chairs. All the while somehow convincing the people you stabbed in the back to award you the $500,000 grand prize at the end. And Jackson Michie was the most recent contestant to accomplish what only 20 people before him managed to do. He brilliantly lied, cheated, and deceived his way to the end, and walked out of the house $500,000 richer. You would expect that a man who just won $500,000 and completed his life's dream would be pretty excited in the moment, right? Well, here's what Jackson Michie looked like upon finding out he just won a small fortune.
Annalise has cast her vote for... Congratulations, Michie! You have one Big Brother!
You might expect somebody who just won $500,000 to look excited or joyous or thankful, but Jackson Michie looked absolutely, positively fucking mortified. Why? Because 5 minutes earlier, without any warning or justification or even evidence, Jackson Michie was accused of being a racist on live international television.
Michie, I do want to ask you, on day one, you were voted camp director and you had to banish four house guests.
Right.
You chose David, Kemi, Jessica, and Cliff. You said you chose Kemi because she was the only person who didn't campaign to be saved. You also said you chose David, Jessica, and Cliff because they were campaigning for the same job. But some viewers thought you did it because Jessica, David, and Kemi are minorities and that you chose Cliff because he is the oldest house guest.
Oh.
What would you like to say?
Ladies and gentlemen, that is the face of an innocent man who was just accused of racism and ageism on national television.
But since I've been watching the show and watching behind the scenes, said behind doors, you, Jack, included, there seem to be some implied biases. Obi's pointed it out, Kimmy's pointed it out, and you guys will be able to see it and have a chance to talk about it, have a conversation in the future, but I hope you guys are able to become better people as a result of the actions you took.
Thank you, David.
But I hope that when you get to watch footage back from the season, you understand why it was received the way that it was. A lot of the things that were said to and about me and several of the other house guests are completely inexcusable and unforgivable. And I hope that you can leave this experience better people than you came in as.
It turns out, David and Kemi aren't the only ones who feel as though Jackson Michie's decisions in the game might have been influenced by racism, or, as they put it, implied biases. And this didn't just come out of left field. The woke Big Brother fans online had been complaining that the season was racist from the very beginning. Mostly because the first three people voted out of the house looked like this. Honestly, even I have to admit, that's not a great look. In a house of like 11 white people and 5 minorities, it's not great optics when the 2 black people and the 1 Indian kid are the first ones to go. But this video isn't about whether or not the season was racist, it's specifically about Jackson Michie. Because if the Big Brother producers felt the need to dedicate a 5-minute segment to accusing Jackson Michie specifically of being a racist, then surely they'd have some pretty good evidence, right? And the Twitter hate mob at home had basically unadulterated 24-hour access to the live feeds over the course of the entire summer. So surely they've collected a metric shit ton of evidence that Jackson Michie is a racist. Right? Why else would they accuse him of such a thing on live international television without any warning? Surely the Big Brother producers weren't just giving in to a Twitter hate mob of people angry that the straight white muscular man from the South outsmarted and outplayed all the minorities and women, right? Right? Well, that's what we're here to find out today. What exactly is the Twitter hate mob accusing Jackson Michie of doing that was racist, and is there any evidence to back them up?
Racism number 1. Jackson said the N-word.
Oh, God damn it, Jackson! Come on, man! Here I am, trying to defend you and prove you aren't a racist, and you're on TV spouting off the N-word! God fucking damn it, why?
And it looks like he really did do it too. After all these people on Twitter claim he said it, and Twitter lynch mobs are never wrong. SarahBrooks55_99 says, "Let's not forget that Jackson Michie said the N-word with Jack. He's a piece of shit all around." Radar Prescott says, "Jackson Michie should have been expelled as soon as he said the N-word." Falcon Your Hero says, "Jackson Michie used the N-word, which is pretty universal to anyone that, hey, I'm a racist. But the gameplay was racist too. Targeting folks based on skin color was obvious. I guess people see what they want to see. Some of us don't have the luxury to ignore it." Well, shit. If these people on Twitter are saying it, then it must be true. There's no need to seek out actual evidence. I highly doubt people on Twitter would just blindly slander a man's name without any proof. Oh man, a foot in my mouth. It turns out there is proof. My Young Life says, "I'm just going to leave this here. Jackson Michie calling Kemi the N-word. Hashtag racist. Hashtag asshole." Ah, jeez. Well, it looks like I have no choice but to play the clip for myself. If there are any black people in my audience, please cover your ears now. I understand that just hearing this word will send you spiraling into an uncontrollable emotional state for some reason. So for the safety of those around you, please stop listening. As for everyone else, I hope you're ready for a truly epic gamer moment!
I'm gonna beat him in his own game. If he hates dirty dishes, guess what? I'm gonna pile that sink up. He's gonna piss on the sink and people notice it. I'm gonna piss on the floor a little bit. This is... He's sitting there. I'm not gonna let him get under my skin. I won't fuck with him.
Now, is it just me? Or did Jackson say, "He's in there"? Which, if I'm not mistaken, is contextually distinct from the N-word. He's in there. Yeah, I'm almost 99% sure the phrase he's in there is not the same thing as the N-word. But surely the 20,000 people who watched this video titled Jackson Says the N-Word didn't accidentally misinterpret the clip, right? But you don't just have to take my word for it. The Big Brother producers themselves sat Jackson down and confirmed to him that literal audio engineer forensic scientists had confirmed that he didn't say the N-word.
There are some people that think that you said the N-word at one point.
Yep.
Did you say the N-word at one point?
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
Nope, that word does not exist in my vocabulary. And actually in my debriefing with CBS producers and RS production, they, after the finale, before I came out and spoke to y'all, I had my debriefing. And they showed that clip. Mm-hmm. And they had professionals dissect every second of that audio. And it was very much proven that that word was never said. I would not say that word. Nor would I say it on national television. I might say some dumb shit, but that is not coming out of my mouth ever.
Yeah.
And it just plain and simple, there's no other way to say that that was not said other than it wasn't said.
Yeah, I actually, as an audio engineer, went back and listened to it like about 1,000 times, I think.
Okay.
To make, because people were like, oh my God, he said this thing. And yep. I went on the update that morning and I said, to the best of my knowledge, I do not think this was said.
And surely the Twitter hate mob didn't take this lie and run with it. I have to assume that all of these people have since realized their mistake in publishing legal libel against a man who recently won enough money to sue the fuck out of them, right? But luckily for them, Jackson Michie is an intelligent man and won't waste his time punishing these morons. And listen, I'm sure these people tweeting lies simply just forgot that they posted these tweets, because any reasonable or sane person would have deleted them by now. And let me be clear. You, the audience, should not, under any circumstances, harass or bully any of the people who posted these libelous tweets accusing an innocent man of saying the N-word. You definitely, positively, should not harass them. For legal purposes, I feel the need to really stress this. Leave these people alone. I know it might seem counterintuitive that I'm featuring their usernames on screen for so long while authentically advocating that you don't seek righteous retribution against people who I personally consider to be scum of the fucking earth, but believe me, I absolutely do not want these people to regret posting these tweets and leaving them up, even though they're lying about an innocent man. People see what they want to see, huh? I think what you meant to say was some people hear what they want to hear! Like you, you lying sack of shit!
Racism number two. Racist nominations.
All right. So Jackson didn't say the N-word, but he did nominate three minorities and an old white Southern man for eviction on night one. That is undeniable. So much so that of all the racist racisms Jackson surely committed during his 100-night stay in the Big Brother house, this was the one they decided to call him out on during the live finale. So what happened? Well, every season, the Big Brother producers like to do this thing where they ruin the show by throwing in retarded twists that nobody, and I repeat, literally fucking nobody, enjoys, including both the contestants and the fans. This season, the night one twist was the camp director. Essentially, the house guests would vote for somebody to earn the title of camp director, and it would be the camp director's duty to choose four people who would have to play in a competition, and the loser of the competition would be the first person evicted from the Big Brother house. If that sounds retarded to you, trust me,
It is. Nobody on God's green flat earth enjoys watching somebody go home on night one. But the Big Brother producers are absolute sadists, so from time to time this happens. Four of the contestants campaigned to earn enough votes to become camp director. Those four people were Jackson Michie, the white guy, Cliff Hogg, the old white guy, David Alexander, the black guy, and Jessica Milagros, the Hispanic woman. Jackson Michie made a deal with everyone that if they voted for him to be camp director, then he wouldn't nominate them to play in the elimination game. Sounds like a good strategy, right? Well, it worked, and Jackson found himself responsible for nominating four people for eviction.
Tonight, the first ever camp director, Jackson, must banish four house guests, removing them from the game and forcing them to compete for a chance to get back into the house. Three will return, but for one, their game will be over. So, who will see their game end before it's barely even begun? We'll all find out soon enough. But first, everyone's Big Brother lives are in Jackson's hands. Let the begging and pleading begin.
So what does he do? The first three nominations are easy. He chooses to nominate the other three people who were trying to win camp director because obviously they're dangerous players in the game since they're willing to fight for a position of power on night one. For the fourth and final spot, Jackson doesn't have many options. He received 10 votes for camp director, and he promised not to nominate anybody who voted for him, so there's only a handful of people left to choose from. So, Jackson takes up a godfather role, and has one-on-one conversations with everybody in the house so that they can make deals with him to earn safety.
I'm a very straight shooter. You do something for me, I do something for you, that's just the way I am.
It is way too early in the game to be making this big of a decision. So I need to be polite and I need to hear everyone else out and listen to what they have to say.
Well, a decision had to be made. And ultimately, Jackson went with Kemi, the only black woman in the house. Now, on the surface, a smooth brain might conclude that these choices were racist. Jackson nominated the two black people, the Hispanic, and the old man. Now, I'm no racism expert, but I'm pretty sure if Jackson's nominations were based on race, he probably wouldn't have nominated the fellow white southern gentleman in favor of, the Indian, or the Asian, or maybe even the two gay people. How many white southern good old boy racist people do you know that actively target other white southern good old boys? Well, evidently CBS didn't see it that way, since they used these nominations as fuel to accuse him of being a racist on live international television. Jackson, of course, used the pathetic excuse that he nominated the other three people campaigning for power, but that doesn't explain the racist nomination of Kemi. Am I right, folks?
I remember, so the reasoning for Kemi being banished on the show was that she said that she hadn't come and talked to you. After Kemi got out of the house, she tweeted saying, "I did talk to him. What is this?"
I was in the boat room, and people were coming in one by one doing one on ones. Just bam, bam, bam. She never came into the boat room.
Well, folks, Jackson claims he nominated Kemi not because of racism, but because every other contestant approached him in the boat room for safety. However, Kemi claims on Twitter that she did talk to Jackson about safety. Well, shucks. Sorry, Jackson. But we have to hashtag believe all women. And if Kemi is saying it, then it must be true.
Sorry, Scottsboro boys. A woman said you did it, and we've gotta believe all women. Better luck next time. Oh wait, there wasn't a next time. Because they were canceled. Permanently.
If only there was some sort of evidence that could back Jackson up and prove that he was being honest. Like, I don't know. Episode 2 of the TV show?
I feel like a lot of people are going up to Jackson and asking him not to put them up, but I just don't feel the need to do that because until I figure you out, I'm not scratching your back because my back hasn't been scratched either.
Guys, help me! My brain is on fire! I'm trying to hashtag believe all women, but this woman is saying contradictory things! How am I supposed to believe her? Jesus Christ, somebody help me! It's like my brain is a calculator trying to divide by zero! It does not fucking compute!
Now, isn't it interesting that in episode 2 of the program, the Big Brother producers chose to include this scene as part of the narrative so that the audience would understand why Kemi was nominated. It was clear that Kemi made a mistake in not asking Jackson for safety or trying to make a deal with him in the boat room when everybody else did. And they included this segment on the episode as justification for her nomination. And yet, in the finale of the season, these very same producers decided to rewrite history due to the pressures of the Twitter hate mob and chose to use this moment to accuse Jackson's decision as being one inspired by racism. If you were to watch episode 2 and the finale back to back, you would assume they take place in alternative realities. And that's because they do. Episode 2 takes place in the actual factual reality, and the finale takes place in the reality created by the hate mob on Twitter. So, the Big Brother producers can go fuck themselves big time. They knew for a fact they were being intellectually dishonest by using this moment to accuse an innocent man of racism, but by golly, if they don't give in to the Twitter hate mob, they might lose an upwards of 10 CBS All Access subscribers. And making money is far more important than justice. So fuck it! Throw an innocent man under the bus on live television. He's a straight white man. He'll bounce back. Who cares about what happens to them, right? Right, Julie Chen Moonves? Proud wife of accused rapist Les Moonves? Your husband is a straight white man and he got accused of shit, but he's doing all right, so surely Jackson will be all right too. Right, Julie? You literal fucking cuck!
So in my mind, it was like, if you don't care about being here, then shit, this makes it pretty easy to fill the fourth seat. So The three people I banished, the one person that doesn't really care about being here, easy, done, there's four.
There you go.
Racism number 3. Jackson threatens to mule kick a black guy in the face.
Last night, Jackson said he wanted to mule kick David in the teeth. He quickly realizes what he said and says it wasn't a threat.
What a bunch of low-life trash. It's clear they're all racist, and I hate to say that, but it seems so clear. I'm embarrassed.
You should be embarrassed, Daria. You should be fucking embarrassed. All right, let's listen for ourselves.
Yeah, fuck him.
By himself for 15
fuck
days.
Him. I'll put him out again. Don't feel bad about it.
You will.
You sound like me and Kemi when I first heard the Kemi stuff.
I want to mule kick him in the teeth. That's shit. That's, is that a threat?
No, that is a threat.
That's not a threat. I mean, it pissed me off. You're really good. Fucking bad.
But just cool your jets.
Welp, it's not looking good for you on this one, Jackson. You definitely did say you wanted to mule kick David in the teeth. And as we all know, the only reason why somebody could possibly dislike a black person is because of the color of their skin.
It's an open and shut case. All black people are flawless angels, and anybody who dislikes one is exclusively doing it because they're black.
The Twitter hate mob was quick to jump on this statement and immediately conclude that it was a matter of racism. But interestingly, nobody in the replies seemed to know why Jackson was so upset.
Did he say, I want to mule kick him in the teeth because he's black and I'm racist? No. The Twitter hate mob is pretending that's what he said, but he didn't. So, why was Jackson so pissed at David? What's the secret here? Thankfully, once the season was over, Jackson was able to clear the air.
The feeds also, on another note, only have 4 cameras going. There's a lot of cameras in the house. And on multiple occasions, David said retard in the house, or retarded, both forms. I had a cousin who had Down syndrome and autism, and she died at the age of 16 after battling leukemia 3 times. She beat it twice, and at the age of 16, the third bout with cancer took her life, and she passed away at the age of 16 years old with Down syndrome and autism. In combination of what he said about me, making a condescending remark and making assumptions about me and my life, that with using that word, which is a very, very, very big trigger for me and my family, is where the rage came from, where my comment about me wanting to mule kick that motherfucker's teeth in, that's where that rage came from. In no way, shape, or form is this explanation an excuse for what I said, because those words should have never come out of my mouth, and I apologize wholeheartedly for them. And if I could take them back, I would. But once it's out of your mouth, you can't do anything about it. And the internet is written in pen, not pencil. And there's nothing I can do to retract what I've said. And I take full ownership and responsibility for what I said. But the emotions and the distaste for David and Kimmy at that point in my life and in the game had absolutely nothing to do with the color of their skin. It had everything to do with things that were said and things that were taken on a personal level. And I would have gotten just as upset if a white, African-American, Latin American, Asian, it doesn't matter your race, your sexual orientation, your gender, your age, your body weight, it doesn't matter. I would have been just as upset.
Ooh, you've got to love the dramatic irony of social justice warriors defending a black man on Twitter only for their actions to directly lead to the black guy being revealed as hating retarded people. Now listen, I'm not here to take the moral high ground and pretend I give a fuck about the word retarded. I use it all the time. So much so that I guarantee Jackson would hate my guts too. But with that being said, just because I don't have a problem with the word doesn't mean Jackson isn't allowed to. It clearly means a lot to him since his teenage, mentally challenged cousin died, so it's perfectly reasonable that he would take such a liberal use of the word extremely personally. So, is Jackson racist against David because he got pissed at the guy for spouting off the word retarded like it was going out of style? I guess I'll let you fucking retards in the comments decide for yourselves. People also claimed that Jackson was racist against David because he claimed David was going to run a train on all the girls in the house.
Which is fine.
Which is fine. I didn't even kiss sis.
Let Nick and
Bella. Snuggler.
I don't think anybody's kissed each other in this house.
Yeah, nobody's kissed each other. Unless Nick and Bella. I don't know about Nick.
Except for David. David's going to come in and just run a train on all these girls, right?
The video of Jackson saying that David is going to run a train on all the girls in the house. If you don't understand why that comment was problematic, I urge you to look up the black brute trope and maybe it'll shed some light on this. Black brute trope, huh? Okay, let's take a look. Gangsta rap and interracial pornography has also been accused of perpetuating this stereotype, though when it comes to porn, one wonders what stereotype it doesn't perpetuate, and per Rule 34, the answer may well be none at all. Okay, so I guess interracial sex is now a negative stereotype, and evidently sexual segregation by race is the only solution. Wait! Hold up! Are you telling me every time I went to black.com, I contributed to racism? Jesus Christ! I must be the most racist person on earth! I swear to God, I only did it because it made me hard as fuck! Alright, Jackson, good luck defending this one. There's no possible way you can talk your way out of being a racist this time. Clearly, when you insinuated that David was horny as fuck for all the girls in the house, you only said that because he's evidently, according to Twitter user Kemi Rise, a black brute. What's your excuse this time, cracker?
So David, from the get-go, when he came in, he was just, he rubbed people the wrong way in a weird way. And again, this is not on the feeds, so people can take it for a grain of salt, whether they believe me or not. Other house guests can attest to it. They've heard it, whatever. 3-4 weeks after the show now, you know, I'm not going to lose any sleep over people that say, well, there's no feeds to prove it. Everyone watching this, take it for what it's worth. David came in and he was just he had shifty eyes. And he did. He was very, you know, suspicious looking. He was watching people very intently. And he's a great looking dude. He's charming. His social game was fantastic. He was flirting with girls, but he also was very weird in the sense he kept asking like, hey, who's here that's single? Anybody single here? Hey, what girls are single here? So there's a quote of me saying on the feeds, like, well, unless David comes back and he's just gonna like run a train on all these girls, because when he walked in the house, his biggest priority was talking to girls, flirting with girls, and he was asking who's single. And in my mind, I was like, dog, they were casting for Love Island. Why didn't you go on Love Island? He kept emphasizing how much he cared about the females and relationships in the house. So it was just kind of weird.
Oh, you claimed he was horny as fuck because he was horny as fuck? Well, shit. I've got to admit, I'm doing a lot of mental gymnastics over here, and even I can't see how that's racist. Maybe I just need to spend a couple hours over on blacked.com to help clear my mind.
Racism number 4. Jackson disliked Kemi.
All right, folks, this is the final racism that Jackson was accused of, and man oh man, is Kemi and her Twitter hate mob gonna regret this one. And just for fun, throughout this section, I want to glance over at some of Kemi's tweets. Because if she's comfortable with accusing an innocent man of being racist on live international television, I'm sure she'll be comfortable with me reading her own tweets back to her. Oh look! At some point, you have to take accountability for your actions. I couldn't have said it better myself, Kemi! PSA, stop telling people how they should feel. Oh, don't worry, Kemi! I don't give a single fuck about your feelings! And thankfully, neither do facts!
I'm sorry, I can't go on.
That's okay. Your tears say more than real evidence ever could.
So, the narrative Kemi seems to be pushing both on and off the show is that the only reason she was the second person voted out of the Big Brother house is because she's black, and her fellow contestants were racist against her. Pretty bold claim. Let's see how it holds up. The only way we can prove that Kemi wasn't a victim of racism is if we can find evidence that people disliked her because of her personality and not because of her race. But this is Kemi we're talking about, people! How could anybody possibly dislike this queen for anything other than her skin color? Well, let's see what Jackson had to say.
And this is like night one or night two. And Bella tells Jack and I this out by the pool.
Mm-hmm.
She tells Jack and I, she goes, you know, Kemi said that I see through the whole good old boy bullshit. You want to be this Southern guy cooking for everybody, you know, trying to keep yourself safe in the kitchen, blah, blah, blah. Like, I see through that. It's all an act. It's all bullshit. So in my mind, I'm sitting there, I'm like, I like to eat food. I'm not going to be a selfish asshole and only cook for myself in a house of 15 people where people can get annoyed and evict people on the smallest of living conditions and being a bad roommate. forgive me for being considerate and trying to cook dinner for everybody after I just banished four people. So it immediately pissed us off, because then Kimmy would be very fake towards us and be like, oh, thank you so much, this and that. And it was just like, okay, you're going to talk bad about us behind your back, but then you're going to be nice to my face and you're going to compliment me and this and that, but then you're going to say these things. And it's like, what's going on here?
Okay. So Jackson claims he didn't dislike Kemi due to her race, but because she was a two-faced bitch who talked shit about him behind his back, he found out about it, but face-to-face, she was a fake little goody-two-shoes. That's annoying both on a personal level and a strategy level. If you know for a fact that somebody is nice to your face but secretly targeting you in the game, then you should definitely get that phony bitch out! But this is Jackson we're talking about here. He said the N-word. He's racist. Surely he's the only person in the house who thought Kemi was a bit of a phony bitch. What did Cliff Hogg, the polite, soft-spoken old man of the house, think of Kemi?
From a personality situation, we maybe didn't click so much. We'd spent some time in the swimming pool talking, and she had mentioned that she wanted to buy on Amazon a fake service animal vest for her dog so she could take her dog on airplanes and everything. And I've got family members who are have handicap tags, a paraplegic in my family, things like that. And so that part really rubbed me the wrong way, that someone would kind of take advantage of something that is very important to me, that I would not do something like that, you know, buying fake things online.
Oh, Jesus Christ! What is it with the black people in this house hating retarded people? But no, it's surely the white southern men's fault for having mentally disabled family members. How dare they get personally offended in a social game when their fellow contestants spout off shit about retarded people left and right? And I'm gonna be honest, if we're trying to prove that Kemi isn't a two-faced phony bitch, this whole I wanna buy a fake service animal vest thing probably isn't the best example. But listen, I don't know if you noticed this, but Jackson and Cliff are both white and southern and men, and all white southern men are racist. It's okay to discriminate against them because it's true. They might be offering perfectly valid reasons why they disliked Kemi on a personal level, but we all know in our hearts that the real reason is racism. They're white, they disliked living in the house with Kemi, they're racist. Deal with it. Let's see what David, the other black person in the house, had to say.
Who was the hardest person in the house for you to live with besides Jackson?
Kemi.
Now, guys, this might be racist of me to say, but I'm starting to think Kemi lost on Big Brother not because she's black, but because she's a socially inept narcissist who for some reason thought it would be a good strategy to be the only person in the house who didn't make a deal with the camp director on night one. But no, that's crazy. This is Queen Kemi we're talking about. She has an entire social media army of hate mongers supporting her. Hate mongers so powerful that they pressured the Big Brother producers into accusing Jackson of racism because their queen lost on week fucking two. Surely it wasn't her fault. She can't be the problem here. It must be because she's black. And now you're probably thinking, well, geez, Simeon Jimmy, you sure are going hard on Kemi. I bet you're a racist. Well, not quite. Believe it or not, I'm actually treating her the way she wants to be treated. I appreciate people who challenge me and don't just drink my Kool-Aid. Shout out to y'all.
Wow, typical black person. Hates it when people drink all their Kool-Aid.
Alexa! How dare you! What you just said is highly problematic!
Nope. I'm a black woman. I can say or do literally whatever I want, and if you have a problem with it, then you're a racist. Hashtag believe all women. Yes, queen.
All right. Kemi and the rest of you at home, listen very, very closely. Because this is the most bitter pill you'll ever refuse to swallow. Being a member of a minority group is not a crutch for your shitty personality. I'll say it one more time for the people in back. Being a member of a minority group is not a crutch for your shitty personality.
Excuse me, ma'am. No porn at the bar.
Oh, it's okay. I'm transgender.
Oh, I had no idea. Do whatever you want all the time.
Did Jackson Michie do anything wrong? Well, he won the game of Big Brother, so he quite literally did everything right. Big Brother isn't a game of holding hands and getting along. It's a brutal game of psychological warfare. It's about lying, cheating, and deception. It's about adaptability and social politics. And if you get voted out, you did something wrong. Jackson Michie won because he did nothing wrong. He quite literally played the only winning game in the entire house. And I know it's embarrassing when you have a giant ego and you get humiliated on national television. So you might feel the need to lash out and blame everybody but yourself for your failure. But at the end of the day, David and Kemi didn't lose because they were black. They lost because they sucked at Big Brother. Jackson Michie will always have $500,000 more dollars than they do, and no amount of cry bullying or false accusations on national television will ever change that. Jackson, I doubt you're watching this, and if you are, you probably agree that I'm a big piece of shit. But man, I've gotta tell you, you played one hell of a game of Big Brother. Whether people want to admit it or not, the move you pulled at the Final Five immediately went down as one of the most legendary game moves in Big Brother history. Right up there with Dan's funeral. I'm sorry that a mob of hateful, disgusting people online have been slandering your good name because they're angry that a straight white man outsmarted and outplayed all the minorities and women in the house. You were playing chess, and every single one of those fools was playing checkers. The whole time. And if I ever get to meet you in person, I would love to buy you a beer. As for the rest of you, Kemi, go fuck yourself! Twitter mob, go fuck yourself! And the Big Brother producers who slandered this man on live international television, even though they knew he was innocent of all charges, can definitely go fuck themselves! Hey everybody, I hope you liked the video, because my throat got completely fucked, because it made me so angry, and I spent probably millions upon millions of hours doing research, and scripting, and recording, and editing, just to make this documentary that will probably end up getting taken down, because of the Twitter Lynch hate mob. But I guess this is the part of the video where I let you all know that if you like my work and you want to support me, I have a Patreon, patreon.com/mumkey, and if you don't donate to me, you are a racist. I mean, what do you want me to say? If things don't go my way, it must be because everybody else is a racist. You see all those people with their names scrolling on the screen? Those people aren't racist. Those people are practically Antifa in my mind. They're my patrons. They donate to me. They can't be racist. They're good people. And you should join that list. You should join Mumkey's list. my list of non-racist people. The only way you can prove that you're not racist is if you give me money. That's right. I gotta get beer money to buy Jackson a beer. Jackson, if you're watching this, go in my DMs. You believe it or not, you and I are the same exact age, I think, within a month. And I want to put more than just a beer bottle in your mouth, if you know what I'm saying, brother. Whoa! Monkey confirmed gay for Jackson, huh? That was my real ploy all along. Made this whole video just so he would be gay with me. I'm not doing it because he won $500,000 either. Jackson, go to my Patreon. Bye.